على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على يا معشر المسلمين رحمكم الله قد ورد في الحبر أن سيد البشر وشفي أمتي في يوم المحشر سيد الأشراف ومتمم مكارم الأحلاك والأوصاف سيد العرب والعجم سيدنا محمد ابن عبد الله ابن عبد المطلب ابن هاشم ابن عبد مناف أنه قال سعيد الحطيب على المنبر ثم خطب فلا يتكلم أحدكم ومن تكلم فقد لغى ومن لغى فلا ثواب جمعة له أنستوا رحمكم الله فاستمعوا غفر الله لنا ولكم ولوالدينا ولوالديكم ولأستاذينا ولأستاذيكم ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ومولانا رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه وعباد الله الذين اصطفى. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. الحمد لله. We are very honored to have amongst us our respected Mullah Ahmed Tahir. We thank him for accepting our invitation. Mullah will deliver the pre-khutbah talk, the Arabic khutbah, and lead us in the salah, inshallah. Before we hand over, just a reminder, brothers, please follow the masjid from the front. Please follow the gaps. At the same time, please remember to donate generously towards the softness of collection of the maintenance of this masjid. Jazakumullah wa khairan. Without any further delay, I will now hand over to Mullah Ahmed Tahir. Nari takbir. Nari risala.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وآله وأصحابه وأزواجه وآل بيته وأولياء أمته وأهل التوفيق أجمعين إلى يوم الدين. إلى حضرة نبي محمد مصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وكل أنبياء عليه الصلاة والسلام أصحاب الكرام أزواج مطهرات إلى بيت الكربلاء شهيد أولياء الكرام سلسلة قادرية تشتي نقشبندية سرودية شادلية رفاية أشرفية حبيبية كل سلسلة حق الفاتحة وانصر فاتحة وكل مؤمن مؤمنات upon all the believers male and female and all that we have mentioned from all the أنبياء أولياء الكرام وان سورة فاتحة أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب زدني علما ورزقني فهما. جماعة المسلمين, الحمد لله, it's a great honor and a privilege to be here in at the Habibiyah Masjid. And remember, when you recited your Surah Fatiha, we included the maqbara that is adjacent to the mazar, and bil khusus on Hazrat Abdul Latif Sahib and all your parents, those who have passed away, family members and so forth, etc., etc. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير وقال نبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم من عمل بما علم ورثه الله علما ما لم يعلم أو كما قال عليه السلام. Jamaat al-Muslimin, we find ourselves in this month of Sha'ban, and we have just, the month of Rajab just fleeted past us, just went so quick that we didn't even have a time to contemplate on, you know, doing the various ibadats in the month of Rajab, even though it is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal. So the month have come and it is gone. And yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in the Quran, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, inna iddata shuhuri inda Allah ithna ashara, that verily known was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal, in this Quran, fi kitabillah, Isna Ashra, 12 months. Yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal-ard. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. Minha arba'atun hurum. He have made of those 12 months, he have made four of those 12 months sacred. Arba'atun hurum. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal says, Zalika deenul qayyim. This is the established deen. So the month of Rajab has went by. We did not even blink our eye and there the month of Rajab is gone. And so we need to take stock of ourselves. What did we do in this month of Rajab? Because Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam has reminded us that remember the month of Rajab is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal. The month of Sha'ban is my month, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wa sallam says. And then the month of Ramadan is the month of the Ummah. So the month of Rajab, we're supposed to have fasted Mondays and Thursdays, the three white days, do whatever good deeds we could, because this was recommended by the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right? But that month went by and many of us did not even acknowledge or commemorate it. The seventh month in the Islamic calendar. And so now we have phased in from the month of Rajab into the month of Sha'ban. And here again, we get an opportunity. Remember, the seed gets planted in the month of Rajab. The plant gets nurtured and cultivated into a beautiful tree in the month of Sha'ban. So now for those of us who have planted the seed in the month of Rajab, we can now cultivate that beautiful tree into a beautiful fruit-bearing tree, whereby we will get the fruits of that tree in the month of Ramadan. And many things can be said about the month of Sha'ban, but time does not permit us, especially on the day of Jumu'ah. And so I'm going to fast forward a little bit and bring you closer to the time when the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was asked by Usama bin Zaid, Hazrat Usama bin Zaid, that Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, you fasting so much in this month, what is the reason for your fasting? Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Usama bin Zaid was referring to the month of Sha'ban. He says, I fast in the month of Sha'ban in honor of the month of Ramadan. I fast in the month of Sha'ban in honor of the month of Ramadan. And so
because we did not, may not have planted the seed properly in the month of Rajab, we have another chance, right? We have another chance to prepare ourselves for the month of Ramadan, inshallah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the glorious Quran, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبِيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. That will be mentioned many, many times. I'm not going to give you now, go into the details of that. But what I want to talk to you in the short time, all that I can do for myself as a reminder and for all the brothers and sisters that are sitting here today, and for those of you who are online, is a hadith that the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is reported that Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed his companions in the way that we are all sitting here. Possibly Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke and the companions were all sitting like that, and he may have sat upon the mimbar and he spoke to his companions and he says, now the month of Ramadan is approaching. And so he reminds the Ummah, the Sahabi Kiram, his companions, about the month of Ramadan. Remember, look, throughout these various Jumu'ahs you will get, there's another three Jumu'ahs, they will only be speaking about Sha'aban. But we are so delayed, by the time we even look again, open our eyes again, we find we're in the month of Ramadan and we haven't prepared anything. And this is the reason why Nabi Akram Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one salawat upon the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa ashabi wa barik wa sallim. So Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam found it necessary to remind us of the coming of the month of Ramadan, the preparation of this month of Ramadan. And so this one hadith, which was mentioned, and I may not get an opportunity to speak to you about it again. And I wanted to speak to you about it last year. And this hadith, it's a lengthy hadith, so I'm just going to do this hadith. I think by that time we will come to the time where we have to close. An Salman qala khatabana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi akhiri yawman min sha'ban faqal, يا أيها الناس قد أذلكم شهر عظيم مبارك شهر فيه ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. So Salman radiallahu anhu mentions, now he's talking, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reminding the companions now in this month of Sha'aban, and it is reported that as the Salman radiallahu anhu, the last day of Sha'aban, he says, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed his companions, he said, oh people, there comes over you now a great month, a most blessed month, in which lies a night more greater in virtue than 1,000 months. Now, if we did not prepare in Rajab, plant the seed, and nurture the plant into a tree in this month of Sha'aban, how are we going to get the fruits, even of the on the night of Laylatul Qadr? How are we going to get that fruits, Jamaat Muslimin? My point I'm trying to make is that we should not ignore the months that precede the months of Ramadan. And if we ignore that, then we cannot get a fruitful and a highly beneficial month in the month of Ramadan. So this was the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a most blessed month in which lies a night greater in virtue than 1,000 months. Then the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues, says that it is in this month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made compulsory by day and has made the sunnah tarawih by night, and whosoever intends drawing near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by performing virtuous deeds, for such a person shall be the reward like the one who had performed a farad in any other time, and who performs a farad shall be blessed with the reward, right? كَمَنْ أَدَّ سَبْعَيْنَ فَرِيدَةً فِي مَا سِوَاهُ, that he will shall be blessed with the reward of 70 faraid in any other time, right? The hadith continues, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, is reported to have said, right? وَهُوَ شَهْرٌ شَهْرُ الصَّبْرُ وَصَبْرُ ثَوَابُهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Indeed, this is indeed a month of patience, and the reward of true patience is the garden of paradise. We need to practice patience now, not when it comes to the month of Ramadan. We need to practice patience now so that we can prepare ourselves, so when the month of Ramadan comes, we can be our demeanor should be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how we can reap the fruits from that tree. And so the hadith continues, this is indeed the month of patience. The reward of true patience is Jannah. It is the month of sympathy with one's fellow man. And this we're supposed to do throughout the year, throughout our lives, all right? Especially for those who are employers, towards your employees when it comes specifically to this month. And it is the month wherein a true believer's rizq is increased. So if we want real increment in our rizq, the preparation again was supposed to be in the month of Rajab, the month of Sha'aban, and then now the month coming, which is the month of Ramadan. And then the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam reported to have said, whosoever feeds another person that they fasted in order to break his fast at sunset, obviously, right? You know, they make a joke, the children normally in the school, they say, Allahumma inni niman mut may sinni. They make a joke about these kind of things. Sometimes we know the children, when they're small, we need to encourage them. My little kids, they were not even baligh that time. So we used to give them breakfast and say, right now you have to fast for the day. The Sahabi Karam used to also give the children toys to play within the masjid. Because they would cry that we are hungry, we want to break our fast. So even that time, we can understand that little children were going through difficult times when they were fasting, but that encouragement should be given to them, inshallah. So if they're not baligh, give them a good breakfast in the morning. And then, and tell them right now you have to fast for the day. And today, alhamdulillah, the kids are fasting because the tarbiyah was given to them. And so the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whoever feeds a first person that is fasting in order to break his fast, for the feeder there shall be forgiveness of sins and emancipation from the fire of Jahannam. And for such a feeder, there shall be the same reward as the one who have fasted as well. So if I fasted, how many fasts can you keep in a day? Only one. Right? But the reward of many fasts you can get by feeding the one who is fasting. So if you bring a box of dates, you feed 100 people, and you get the thawab of 100 people's fasting. Wow. Look at the amount of ajr that there is in just these little acts. It is no wonder that the azab in the qabr and the azab on the day of mahshar is so severe. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has afforded us every opportunity to get the fuyud and barakat of these great and secret months. Then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by one of the companions, say, Ya Rasulullah, not all of us have the opportunity of, providing, food for the person who's fasted. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وسلم يعطي الله هذا ثواب من فطر صائما على تمرة أو شربة ماء أو مذقة لبن. That the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then replied that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal grants the reward for the person that if he mere feeds a person with a date, he will get the reward of the whole fasting of that person, right? Or even if it is a sip of water, or if it is a drink of water or a sip of milk. This is what Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam have. And then obviously in this month of Sha'aban, you will find people come to the masjid on a Monday, and then they come and they sit and they break their fast. Try to break your fast at home. If you are the person that's only, and if your family is not requiring to be at home, come try to fast, break your fast in the masjid. Let people see that you are fasting. Let it be a reminder for us. All right? Then the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued to say, "Wa huwa shahrun awwaluhu rahma." And then this month coming, the beginning of it is the mercy of Allah subhanahu. "Wa wasthuhu maghfirah." And the middle of it is the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa akhiru aidkum minan nar, and the last of it is the freedom from the fire of Jahannam. Right? So this is the month which brings Allah's mercy, the middle of it which brings the forgiveness, and the last of it which brings the emancipation or the freedom from the fire of Jahannam. Now if we look at Ramadan, Sha'ban first of all also has 5 letters. Sha'ban, what is Shin, Ain, Ba, Alif, Noon. Right? So each letter has a significance. Similarly, the month of Ramadan also has a significance. Awwaluhu rahma, the Ra for rahma, right? the meme for maghfirah, you understand, and so forth. So in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us all these great ni'mas. And whosoever lessens the burdens of his servants, in other words, his bondmen or people that are working for them, in this month, Allah will forgive him and free him from the fire of Jahannam. Right? And in the month, in this month, the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, referring to Ramadan now, that there are four things that we should continue to perform in great number, which shall be to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? The one, while the others would be with which you cannot do without, right? And the other is that which you should do in great quantity. And what are those things? The Nabi Muhammad, and here it comes. Many people say, ne jikani pachani masjid muniya. You go to Johannesburg, Durban, you find, you go to the masjids, you find that the people are quiet. And here in Cape Town, alhamdulillah, in some places in Johannesburg, you find they will do la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah lahul mulku wa lahul hamdu yuhyi wa yumeet wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadeer. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلى الله وسلم عليه. This is what Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam recommended that we should do profusely in the month of Ramadan. And ons do not, we do it loudly. And when we do it loudly, we remind the youth that this is what you have to do. Khan Johannesburg, go to Johannesburg, go to other places where they're reciting softly. The youth don't know what to recite. Amal is net. And nobody knows, basically now you must send a child to madrasa to go and learn that when they can learn it in the environment of the masjid, and also a practical aspect can also be showcased to your child as well. And then also the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, then you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrance into the garden of paradise. And this was recommended, and we recite it also loudly, right? Allahumma innaka afuun rahimun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna ya kareem, right? We find that, right? So we recite that also loudly. And many people, some foreigners came in, from Indo-Pak, and they say, you people are making music out of this recital and all that kind of thing. They don't even have the music. They don't even have the recital, never mind anything else. Jamaatul Muslimin, let us continue with our traditions, right? The Islamic traditions, that which Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam recommended, recite La ilaha illallah profusely, right? Wahdahu la sharika la, that what I've recited to you. And then also, Allahumma innaka afuun rahimun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna ya kareem. I cannot go into that particular aspect of that askar where you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. It is very, very beautiful. And then the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Waman saqa sa'iman saqahu Allahu min hawdi sharbatan. Then the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that, and whoever gives a person water to drink, Allah shall grant the giver a drink from my fountain, from the Hawd. Such a drink, whereafter that person shall never again feel thirsty until he enters into the garden of paradise. Jamaatul Muslimin, really a great injustice. Time is caught up with us. So many things, so many aspects. But I feel that it is important that we focus on preparing ourselves in this month of Sha'aban for the coming of the month of Ramadan. Wa akhiru da'wahum anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Sayyid jazakumullahu khairan jazah to our respected Mullah Ahmad Tahir for his inspirational talk. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all the hidayah and tawfiq. Just a few announcements. Firstly, make dua shifa for Sister Dildar Date, who is the wife of our Muazzin, Abdul Majid Date, who is in hospital. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her shifa kamil and all those who are sick, inshallah. Ameen. And then just to remind the brothers, a special dua, please make dua for Palestine, for those who are suffering in Palestine, in Jenin, and for those who have suffered from the earthquakes in Turkey. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the plight and suffering all Muslims and all non-Muslims around the world, inshallah. Everyone, inshallah. Ameen, thumma ameen. The CTIEC announces a pre-Ramadan souk 2023, 3rd, 4th, and 5th of March 2023, Masjid al-Karim Center, on behalf of the CT Cape Town Islamic Educational Center, 11th Avenue, Eagle Park, start after Jumu'ah Salah, inshallah. Please see the notice board for further details, inshallah. Then also, there's been a request. Please announce that the Musallis are kindly requested to refrain from setting up chairs by the shoe racks and at the back of the masjid, close to the ramp. It creates a safety risk and an inconvenience to other Musallis entering and exiting the masjid. Next week, a dedicated area will be set up on the flat road side. Shukran for your cooperation and understanding. Shukran wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين رب اغفر لنا بالخير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي للصلاة
الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباد الذين استفى أما بعد أيها الإخوة أوصيكم ونفسي أول بالتقوى الله يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم قال الله تعالى أيضا بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن عدة شهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم قال الله تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير وقال نبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده وقال نبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم من عمل بما علم ورثه الله علم ما لم يعلم أو كما قال عليه السلام بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات وذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى ملك كريم جواد بر رؤوف رحيم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين والمؤمنات إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
اللهم احتن لنا بالخير إلهي بحرمة القرآن العظيم والنبي الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اتقوا الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. اللهم صل على شفيع المذنبين سيدنا ومولانا ومرشدنا وراحة قلوبنا وطبيب ظاهرنا وباطننا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وباتنا محمد طب القلوب ودوايا وعافي الأبدان وشفايا ونور الأبصار وضيايا وقوة الأرواح وغزايا وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وآل بيته وأولياء أمته وأهل طاعتك أجمعين إلى يوم الدين خصوصا على خير البشر بعد الأنبياء بتحقيق أمير المؤمنين سيدنا أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى مزين المنبر والمحراب أمير المؤمنين سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى كامل الحياء والإيمان أمير المؤمنين سيدنا عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه وعلى مظهر العجائب والغرائب أمير المؤمنين سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنهم وكرم وجوههم وعلى إمامين الهمامين أمير المؤمنين سيدنا أبي عبد الله الحسن والحسين رضي الله تعالى عنهما وعلى أمهما سيدة النساء سيدتنا فاطمة الزهراء رضي الله تعالى عنها وعلى ستة الباكة من عشرة المبشرة وسائر المهاجرين والأنصار وتابعين الأبرار خيار إلى يوم القرار رضوان الله تعالى لهم أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم. اللهم اغزل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يعمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله تعالى يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وجل وأتم وهم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقم الصلاة.
Is more for Jamaat al-Muslimin. Please fill the gaps. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. استوى اعتدلوا سوي صفوفكم رحمكم الله استقيموا صلاتكم صلي صلاة مودع straighten yourself stand shoulder to shoulder and make your salah as if it is your very last. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أخوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أستغفر الله الذي هو التواب
الرحيم الذين ونتوب إليك.
استغفر الله الذي هو التواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو
الحي القيوم ونتوب إليك.
استغفر الله العظيم
والتواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا
هو الحي القيوم
ونتوب إليه
ونسألك توبة ومغفرة إلا إنه التواب الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك يعود سلام تبارك ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. اللهم إنا نسألك خير هذه اليوم اليوم الجمعة فتحه ونسره ونوره 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 وبركته وهداه، ونعوذ بك من شر ما فيه ومن شر ما بعده. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر المجاهدين في فلسطين وكل مكان يا ربنا يا رب الكريم. اللهم رب الناس أزم الباس، اشفي أنت الشافي يا الله، اشفي أنت الشافي يا الله، لا شفاء إلا شفاءك، شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولأستاذنا ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. اللهم افتح لنا بالخير واختم لنا بالخير واجعل واكم أمورنا بالخير، بيدك الخير والعافية إنك على كل شيء قدير. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون، الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. بفضلك دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحياتهم فيها سلام، وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
قبل الله مني ومنكم a wonderful, beautiful, glorious Jumma Mubarak to each and every one of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.